जगन्नाथ स्वामी नयनपथगामी भवतु मे ओम श्री मातृ मीरारविंदो शरणं मम ओम श्री सद्गुरु साई नाथाय नमः विजय शिल्पी प्रेसिडेंट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द स्कूल एंड चिल्ड्रन इट्स माय ग्रेट प्लेजर टू बी विथ यंग पीपल I have also taught for about 3.5 years, of course at the graduate and the postgraduate level, not in a school. And teaching school is both difficult, challenging and happy. I don't know what are the joys and frustrations of your teachers, because that's natural. Children will be mischievous, they are growing up and they are trying to do many things. But what is important is that each child is unique. That's the first thing we have to understand. And although many of you have just heard about your children making into the Ivy League and other quote unquote prestigious institutions, but I don't think that is the goal, that can be the goal, because that's the, everybody is trying to do that. And I'm sure most of your minds might be how I'm going to make it to the AIIMS, how I'm going to make it to the IIT or etc., etc. That's all right at a certain level. But what is beyond that? Because if you go to a big software company like Microsoft, there may be thousands. I think TCS is employing almost 3 lakh employees. So you are one of the, you are in a herd. How many will actually be making a mark within that system? Very few, but you are still running after to be a member of that herd. That's all right, as I said, as a part of the system. But what is important, I didn't want to talk typically, give an inspirational speech and, you know, etc., which is now a genre of, there are many books, the two types of books which are being sold is something related to mythology and the other is related to self-improvement, so-called inspirational books. I think Bahubali must have sold more copies than most of the other, because now that is a fashionable thing. So if you have a dose of mythology, then it sells. And there is some kind of a fashion today. And Mr. Nilakantan, who was there in the Kalinga Literary Festival the other day, he's also becomes a star. So that's one way of looking at it, that you can do much more than what your so-called narrow quote-unquote profession, whether it is information technology or medical or engineering. Very few people who do engineering and IIT actually do any engineering post passing that institution. So it's a national waste and also waste of your own time. If you seriously look at it, there are different ways of looking at it. Anyway, it may give you a good career. Whatever, I really wanted to talk to you about something very close to my heart, and I think it is the children who are the right people to address this topic and these issues. And if it's only the children who can make a difference. So I spoke about it to a school children in Barhampur, which is one of the largest school, and they have also had their own success. About 51 children had made it to the medical from that single institution, and they were all honored. Although they were already studying in medical colleges, they were called and they were honored. Some half a dozen people had made it into the IITs. So it's a good school in terms of the success that we measure today, because we seems to measure the success of the school mainly in these parameters. That's all right. As I said, that has to be there, because some kind of excellence has to be there. But I will talk to them on certain topic, and I'm going to talk to about the same thing, and that is water, weather, wind and waste, the 4 W's. Because the situation has slided badly on these four fronts. And it is, we are as if have a collective wish for, rather we have a national wish. And in fact, the humanity seems to be having that wish of committing collective harakiri. It is as simple as that, that they all want to jump like bhed chal. We all know what are the problems, but we all seems to be still hurtling down that path as if from the Mount Everest we are want to just come down and drop dead, because the world is going to come to a knot if something is not done today, this very moment, starting with this very moment. The water scarcity has been dramatically highlighted recently by the non-availability of water in Johannesburg, the capital city of a very certainly upcoming prosperous country. And it's not backward in any sense, in that sense. Not only in that continent it is one of the leading, but it is certainly well poised towards development. That is going to happen here in Bhubaneswar. That's going to happen here in Odisha. That's going to happen in India. It's not very far off. It's already knocking at your door. But we seem to be blissfully innocent about things as if it does not exist. Like there is a saying in Oriya that the cat closes its eyes and drinks milk as if and thinks that nobody is observing it. But it is there before our eyes. We seem to be least concerned. It's not my concern. It's not my, I don't have to bother. Somebody else has to bother about it. And this whole attitude that the government has to do something, government will do everything, I think that's a very wrong attitude. It has to start in our own house, in our own habits, in our own culture. If we don't do it now, you are perhaps the last generation. The next generation will I don't know. We have heard in Odisha, you may not have heard, because most of you may not be familiar with the history of Odisha, which is also a sad thing, but we had a great famine of Odisha in the 19th century. And to expiate the sins, to atone for the sins, to make amends for those sins committed because of the death of million people, then the then commissioner made the Ravensa College. So behind Ravensa College is the story of the great famine of course it was a great failure, I don't want to go into details and all that. But we are going to not starve, but do not have water. And that's something which you have to be conscious. And what can you do? I will talk about one or two things which you can do. And the same is the situation with waste. We are all, again, blissfully innocent. Keep on throwing plastic here and there. And unfortunately, India has a dense population. We don't have the landmass like USA. Huge landmass compared to the population. I don't remember the statistics. But you know that already in Bhubaneswar, all of us are citizens of Bhubaneswar. We are all living in Bhubaneswar. You know that Bhubaneswar's solid waste is a very, very serious problem. There was a fight between two villages where it is being dumped. I don't know how many of you have followed that news. That means that problem is also knocking at your door. It is not something happening far away in Mars or in Moon. It's happening right next to your doorstep. We seem to be again blissfully innocent. Let us create any amount of waste. How does it matter? Somebody else is going to clean it up. And somebody is going to take some steps to dispose it. Again, what you have to do is it has to start with us. It has to start with me. That attitude you have to develop and you have to inculcate among others. It said that there is a huge cave and inside it is pitch dark. But the moment you light a single candle, then you can see the darkness disappears. So even in the amidst when we have a very deep problem confronting us, we can start with small efforts. And when just now, when your chairman was saying that you say good morning, when you all of you started shouting, you know, crossing all decibels, then probably I was wondering whether the roof will remain there or not, on a lighter vein. But the point is, if simple efforts are made by individuals, and then that becomes a collective effort, that becomes a group, then it can be solved. I am a self-taught IT professional. I drifted into IT around the 80s when nobody had any understanding of IT in Odisha and nobody had any faith. I was working among non-believers. I'm talking of 1980, I was MD of the Small Industries Corporation. I brought in computers to the state. And then there was a small write-up in the most popular newspaper. There was only one newspaper worth its name during those days, Samaj. They said that this gentleman has something, some screws loose here. Today, you take IT for granted. But I started among non-believers, knowing fully well that this is something which is going to be. So you must have a vision. You must have look ahead. Somebody has to make a beginning. And that beginning on these fronts, I said that you can make a beginning. And you can make a difference. That is the most important thing. There was an interesting WhatsApp message going around. Unfortunately, that hasn't caught the attention of the media, because if there is something salacious, something mischievous, something, you know, naughty, that will make the headlines and that will go viral. But something really good, something really worth emulating, following, that doesn't get the attention of the media. So we are living in a very weird kind of world. And that, what was that news item which was there in the WhatsApp group? That there is one Mr. Tripathi who has retired as the head of Daikin in India, in the commerce, head of commerce in Daikin in India. And Mr. Tripathi is found, he walks every day, takes his morning walk in Forest Park. Some of you can go and watch him if you have the time and inclination. He is picking up these small plastic things which has been thrown and collecting it in a bag and then putting it in a waste bin. The park is something which all of us are using, but we take pleasure in making it dirty. This is a typical Indian attitude today, very, very unfortunate. And India has such a huge tradition of respecting nature. In the Shanti Mantra which is uttered, there is a, you know, particular thing. It says Apa Shanti, then Vanaspatayo Shantihi. Vanaspati is the vegetables. We respect the vegetation because we have to understand that we can live well so long as we use a generic word called environment, but trees, Vanaspati is basically trees. If trees are happy, if trees are allowed to live in peace, they are going to help us. But we seem to have forgotten. And so I was telling you about Mr. Tripathi who is collecting. And there is another story in, I think it is in Sweden or one of the Scandinavian countries. They have now formed, this is what I was telling about somebody, one person starting. Now they also go and they keep, while they are jogging, morning walk or jogging, that everyone takes a small plastic bag or some carry bag and they keep on collecting whatever garbage, plastic bottles and other things which are thrown, and then they put it in the place where it is. So there is a small video film which was making the rounds in the, again in the WhatsApp group I saw, and then I sent it to some people. But the point is, those things don't get noticed. So I was talking, this highlights the problems we are having with water. Now, those of us who have lived in this area, Katak, Bhuvaneshwar, we have seen that Mahanadi used to get flooded every year. Water supply of Bhuvaneshwar, how many of you know where from the water is coming? You may be, again, very innocent. Many of your adult members in the family would also be innocent. Mahanadi branches off into Katjodi, then Katjodi branches off into Kuakhai. As you go towards Katak, the first river you will cross is Kuakhai. And there were some intake wells in the river bed from which the water is brought. Later on, of course, the Naraj Barrage, one connection has been made and you are getting water from that. But what is the situation? Last year I saw that Kuakhai was not full, even one day. How are you going to get water? They had to dig a deep channel from Katjodi to that place and make available water, because certain areas of Bhuvaneshwar are still getting supplied from that Palasuni, that point where this pump is located. A situation will come, we will not have drinking water. Mahanadi problem, some of you may have vaguely heard about the Mahanadi problem, may not have interest. You are blissfully letting the tap go, run, they let the water run off, filtered water after a lot of money has been spent. It's a precious resource. It is a finite quantity. It's not infinite. And whatever can be generated, there is a saying in Oriya, Basi khaile noi bali sare, that if you keep consuming without adding, that whatever huge resources you may have, that will get exhausted sooner or later, whereas sooner than later. So how are you? I am just talking about highlighting the problems, then I'll say a few things which you can do and all of us can do together. Wind. I lived in Delhi, I shifted to Bhubaneswar primarily because my granddaughter had serious problem about pollution and she started developing early tendencies which would have led to asthma, and she is now a student here. Primarily, that was the primary reason why I shifted from Delhi. But what do I find here? Bhubaneswar, the dust pollution is quite bad. I live in Shahid Nagar, and the dust pollution is so high, even with double windows, you will find huge amount of dust. When you wash the floor or clean the windows, you will find it's all dark. Two types of dust particles are coming. One, of course, is simple dust, mostly construction road dust, which in any case is not good for you if you take it. Second is the exhaust fumes. Then you will find very, very dark, very, very micro particles coming, nanoparticles type of thing. And what is it? It is highly carcinogenic. You understand what is carcinogenic? Something which causes cancer. And all of us are ingesting, all of you are ingesting it, whether you like it or not. So it's not as if it is something happening somewhere else. And believe me, I had 3 bouts of congestion. February 17, September 17, and February 18. Now, of course, I have come out of it after taking some medicines and doing some exercises and all that. That means pollution and air is very, very bad, and it's going to become worse. And all of us have to confront this problem. Let's not brush it under the carpet. If you brush it under the carpet, you are only going to suffer. Your children are going to suffer. I don't know what will be the future. I can't just think, imagine, visualize what will be the position of the generation after your generation. That means 2 generations after that. Your grandchildren. So if you don't do something today and now, it's not going to get rectified. Then finally, weather. Weather has many things, so I will not really go into detail. It is the deterioration of weather, why it is happening, but what you can all feel in the last 3-4 years you must have seen, it's highly unpredictable. It has become highly unpredictable. You expect water at a certain season, you won't get it. You expect winter, it is not there. You don't expect winter, there is frost in Koraput railway station, it's almost like snow. So all kinds of topsy-turvy things are happening. Things are going awry. Things are going horribly wrong. Now let's start what we can do in our own small ways. Let's discuss a few things. Water. First of all, we have to be economical in the use of water. Very simple. Few things have been standard things to do. Tell your father, or some of you must be shaving daily. Don't let the tap run while you are shaving. Take it in a small mug. If you are taking bath, take bath in a bucket rather than opening the shower and letting a lot of water go. Manage to do with less. In Rajasthan, people, you know, that's a very dry area. So they take a huge brass plate or a big plate, they stand on the plate and wash. And that water they use for sort of watering a plant or something. So water has to be less use is most important. Then second, conserve as much rainwater as possible. And rainwater, that means if you can even leave space of 10 feet by 10 feet in a area, in a plot, that will conserve some water. That will, because water is not going down to the, so that it is not recharging the water sources, aquifers and other sources. And that is happening right before our eyes. Now it is fashionable to have flats and people are very proud, oh, I am living in such and such flat. It has got a big club, it has got a swimming pool, I can go to the gym, do some exercise. And of course the elders will say, oh, there is a bar, it is the stock of the best wine and etc., etc., which of course I don't know, understand anything about it, because I don't have softness for inebriating liquids. So point is, you have to conserve water. Second, I read a very interesting, again in the WhatsApp message I got, somebody in Mumbai, that gentleman, he suddenly realized about this problem of water, and you find a leaking tap, it is dripping water, you know, drop by drop. Do you know, if there is a small leak, in a month's time, about 1,000 liters of water is going waste. And what is that water? It is filtered water. To get the filtered water, you are using chemicals or whatever it is, then you are using energy also, because you are pumping that much extra. So what he has done in his own, that is what I was saying, what can you do? In a small way, every Sunday he started going out with a plumber and went house by house and identified leaking taps and repaired them. And in this process, he has repaired now lakhs of it. And the process, he has saved millions of gallons or millions of liters of water. Can you do something? When you walk around, someday, because you come early to the school, but on Sundays, go around your own colony. You will find many houses, after the overhead tank is filled, it is, water is just, you know, like coming down. Huge water is flowing, as if Ganga is flowing down the hair of Shiva. Everyone wants to have that experience. They want to visualize, ah, Ganga has come through Shiva and now it is going down. But that is what is happening. I have seen it myself. You go to institutions, those of you in Sirpur area, you will find that agriculture college, there are many government buildings. Children can make a difference. Visit those houses. Tell them, please fit a sensor. If you can't, there are old people, they don't know when the pump, they have started the pump, they don't know when it is overflowing, they're not able to close it. Try and help and find some innovative solution. If you can do it for 10 houses, you have done your bit. And imagine if 5,000 children of SAI are doing it, how much water they will be conserved. It's not as if we can't do anything. There are big things have to be done. Some have to be done by government, some have to be done by the community, some have to be done by the local administration, but you can also do something. Tell your parents, tell your family members, create this awareness, conserve water. We know, supposing Mahanadi water is giving a big problem. It has become a big problem. We don't know what is going to be the result. The tribunal has been formed. We don't know. What is happening, going to happen to the farmers who are dependent on that water? We must think of some solution. If we get that water, fine. But should we not prepare ourselves against some eventuality? I read a very interesting news item. One lady, not very educated, in Sambalpur area, she, her husband is working, teacher in some school. Then she found that they had a small piece of land, it was not yielding much. So he found out about drip irrigation, took some initiative. Now she is getting about 6 lakhs per annum from her own farm. Just imagine if such, that's about 2 acres per acre, which is quite a good. You can't get that much from rice. Certainly not. Now if that idea you are able to transmit that idea to one farmer, either as an individual or as a group of four children, let's go visit some villages and let's pass on this idea. There is a success story. It's not something unknown. It's not rocket science, to use a cliche. It's not rocket science, but it can be done. Israel, all of you know, Israel very famous for conserving water. It's a desert area basically, but they have pioneered the drip irrigation. So with less water, in fact, the plants, which crops and other things, if you are able to give them regulated water, you will get much better yield and they will have less of disease. So how to make the best use of water? What is available? We have to be conscious of that. And whatever is getting runoff has two big problems. One problem is water is flowing away to the sea. That is one problem. So the good water we are not able to collect and use it for our needs. The other thing is that it carries with it a lot of topsoil, which is the most fertile component of the soil. And how to tackle that? How to tackle that is only by planting trees. We have huge catchment areas for Mahanadi. We have 4 or 5 big projects. Mahanadi, of course, is our oldest. Then we have Kolab, Indravati, and Balimela 3, all located in Koraput district. And we have one more big project in Dekanal, Rengali. We can, I had of course initiated long time back large afforestation programs, but I'm not very sure that much has happened beyond that. But if you can take a resolution, go to a village that we will plant every year 1 million trees. Or if school can take that, we will plant 1,000 trees in the catchment area of you. The temperature will come down. You will enjoy your summers. Go to the Chandka forest area, say that we want to plant trees. In fact, one idea I had is that let the tree be owned by the child. You can collect 2-3 year saplings so that it will survive. Survival rate will be better. Dig a pit which is 3 to 4 feet, put some good soil and some fertilizer, plant it, put it in the rainy season, then it will grow. Some other say that just take seeds and throw them. Some will, the statistics is that you toss a coin, one will be head or tail. So what is the chance? 50%. So we just throw the seeds, 50% of the trees may sprout. But what is most important, these are not prescriptive things I am trying to tell you. I am trying to tell you is that you start thinking about it. It's your future. Think alone. Think together in small groups. Think together in large groups. But what is more important is that all of you will, as I said, I am quite sure that all of you will succeed in material life. I am quite sure about that. You will get into Pennsylvania, you will get into Harvard, you will get into IIT Kharagpur, you will get into, you know, National Law School, etc., and you will do wonderful careers. Please, take a resolution that whatever I do, when I earn, I will try to tackle these 4 problems. I will help some cause. I will myself take some initiatives. So, a tithe, T-I-T-H-E, tithe means it's a kind of a short portion of your earnings. You please try to and make this resolution. Just imagine if thousands of children make this resolution and try to do something and make a difference. What a difference it will make to the country. And don't wait for others. Don't wait for others. Somebody else will do it for me. Start keeping your own environment, your house clean. Try to avoid plastics. I don't think we have come to a stage where we can make it zero, but try to make it, make a effort towards that. When your parents are going to the market to get vegetables, tell them to carry a small bag, cloth bag, and not get use plastics. Try to. You know the problem of plastic, all of you may be known, and there is another bigger problem which we don't seem to understand at all, this styrofoam foam. Many of you may not, the technical word you may not know, but this white thing, you know, it is with which you get this TVs packed and other things because it's a good cushion. That styrofoam foam will not degenerate in 1,000 years. It should be banned because it can't be recycled also. Whereas the plastic you can recycle, styrofoam form it's almost impossible to recycle. So there has to be a movement. And then some of you may be innovators, think what kind of packaging we can develop so that styrofoam form can become obsolete. That's also a challenge. Those of you want to work in the research area, technology area, you can start working on those areas. But the short point I'm trying to make is that try to make a difference from today, from now, this very moment. Because the problem confronting us is not far off. It is right before our eyes. So I think I have given you enough gyan so for today. But I give you my love and I hope sincerely that all of you will start thinking and do something on your own. Not because I have told you. Not because I have told you, but because you think that it is good, please do it. If that I can trigger that thinking process, I think my job has been done. Thank you, and thank you, Silpi, and Vijay, and the principal.